I was invited to the State Young Writers Conference out at Cheney, which is at Eastern Washington University. And I did want to embarrass my son, you know, and I was going to behave myself because I had to live there then. It was a chore. But I got on the stage. It was an enormous auditorium. There are 2,700 young faces out there, none of them with any prospects anybody could detect. And off to the side of the stage was the suit and tie crowd, the people from the school district and the principals, and the main speaker following me was from the Chamber of Commerce. Well, something inside of me snapped. And I got to the microphone and I looked out over that multitude of faces and I said something to the effect of, "You're about to be told one more time that you're America's most valuable natural resource. Have you seen what they do to valuable natural resources? Have you seen a strip mine? Have you seen a clear cut in the forest? Have you seen a polluted river? Don't ever let them call you a valuable natural resource. They're gonna strip mine your soul. They're gonna clear cut your best thoughts for the sake of profit unless you learn to resist. Because the profit system follows the path of least resistance. And following the path of least resistance is what makes the river crooked." Well, that was great gnashing of teeth and rending of garments. Mine. I was born to the door, screaming epithets over my shoulder, something to the effect of, "Make a break for it, kids! Flee to the wilderness! The one within, if you can find it." Well, I wrote them a nice letter, though, as I oozed out of the state, headed for Nevada City. I sent it to their little literary magazine. I respect kids. I love especially little kids. Little kids are assholes. But they're their own assholes. See, it's when you grow up and be somebody else's asshole, we're all in trouble. You're like bankers and B-52 pilots.